Okay, hello everybody. This is our first attempt at posting a video for Crafties 915. Today we're making a black hoodie. This is a black large hoodie. The weather's perfect for hoodies. And so whenever you're working with hoodies, make sure that you use one of these pads and place it in between the front and the back of the hoodies. Okay? With the hoodies, what you want to avoid is avoid having your hood towards the back of the press. Okay, because if you do, you run into the chance of getting this dirty. There's like grease and oil back here. So if this were a white hoodie or a light colored hoodie, you would be getting this thing dirty. So what you want to do is you want to do like what most screen printers do, and you want to go ahead and print backwards with the collar towards you and the pockets towards the back. Make sure that your hoodie is centered. I'm going to go ahead and turn on this light because my eyesight is not the best anymore. So make sure that your hoodie is centered. And what helps you with the hoodies is that you have this as the center of your garment. So that helps a lot. Make sure your pad is centered. And then another thing is that you want to make sure that the pressure is correct. Okay, so we're pressing a iColor 600 transfer onto this. So this requires about a 6 bar pressure, which is about a firm to heavy pressure. Right now, I just finished pressing a t-shirt, so it was at 6, but when I try to go ahead and close this and test the pressure, it's going to go ahead and rise up all the way to about a 7 or an 8. So I'm going to have to loosen the pressure a little bit. Don't forget to warm your garment for about, 5 seconds. Right now my pressure is at 6, so that's perfect. And I already warmed my garment for about 5 seconds. One trick that I learned by trial and error is how to get the center of your transfer right. Never go by the length of the transfer. Okay, always go by the print area of the transfer. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go ahead and fold this in to where the E and the I meet. And that's going to go ahead and mark the center of my transfer. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and put it right there so that you can see. When I folded it, I put my E to the I and then made a little indentation right there. Okay, so that's my center of my transfer. This is my center of my garment. And I'm gonna go ahead and line them up. Don't forget to use your parchment paper to protect the transfer. If you don't use the parchment paper, what happens is that when you pull this up, it's going to go ahead and try to bring the transfer backing paper with it, okay, with friction. And so that's going to go ahead and cause your transfer to not be adhered to the substrate very well. So always use parchment paper. The recommended settings for these iColor standard transfers are 30 seconds at 310 degrees. What I do is I do 40 seconds. Okay, that way I give it a little bit more time so that, the adhesive really attaches, to the fibers, especially like on these hoodies or sweatshirts. You really want that adhesive to attach to the fibers. So What I'm using today, I'm using my Geonite DK20S, which is a very good heat press. I was using this one, my Heat Press Nation 16x20, and it is a great heat press, but I prefer this one. This is a way better heat press. These transfers were printed on my iColor 600 printer, which is over there in the back, and you can see that white one. That is my iColor 600 printer. Okay, so we're done with 40 seconds. Okay, you want to go ahead and bring this garment over to your cooling station. My cooling station is actually the kitchen table, because it has a ceramic tile top, and so it maintains a very cool temperature, okay? So we'll let this cool down for about a minute, and then we'll peel it off, and we'll come back, okay? Okay, so we're back. This thing is completely cooled down. It took about a full minute, you know, for it to go ahead and cool down completely. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do, I'm gonna show you how to peel off these transfers once they are applied. So what we do on a firm surface, I already took out the padding from in between, and on a firm surface, I usually do it at the kitchen table, but I want to go ahead and show you here. Let me go ahead and turn off this light. Okay, or let me go ahead and turn it on. That way you can see the details. Never mind the glare. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and start from one corner and roll it up and work my way, you know, up like this. If at any point this transfer catches on and it's not easy to peel, then you stop, you go to another corner, hopefully the opposite corner, and then come back this way, okay? So we're gonna go ahead and start from this lower left corner, okay? And it should be able to go ahead and peel off, okay? And notice, I'm doing it in a very tight rolling motion, okay? And I usually do it faster, but I want to go ahead and show you, you know, slowly how I do it, okay? I'm trying to go ahead and make sure that I get everything at once with both hands. Okay, and there we go. And so there's the perfect peel. There's a perfect transfer. Throw this away. Now, if you notice, if you zoom in a little bit, on the camera we have my lovely daughter, Samantha. She likes to be called Freddie Mercury. And if you zoom in to this area right here, okay, that is called bleeding, okay? What happened is that the dye bleeded into the transfer, okay, into the image, which my customer, the one who ordered this, doesn't mind. As a matter of fact, he likes that, okay, because it gives it like a vintage look, okay? But if you want to go ahead and avoid this bleeding, you want to go ahead and lower your temperature to about 300 degrees. Instead of 310, to about between 285 and 300 degrees, and that's enough heat for it to adhere, and it won't bleed. Okay, so but this customer likes this look. You know, it gives it, you know, sort of a very mild distressed look. So now that we have our transfer already to do the final press, we place our padding in between the front and the back. Now, if you noticed, this transfer has a very shiny look, okay? It has a sheen to it. Okay? You can leave it like that, but I wouldn't recommend it. Okay, first of all, because it looks kind of, doesn't look very professional, and you need that second press for it to give it a matte look, and for the adhesive to be go ahead and activate it one more time, so that it's gonna last a long time. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do is place this. On my press. And since you already applied the transfer, you don't have to worry about centering all this. You just have to worry about making sure that the padding is covering the whole image. Make sure that your seams are underneath. They're not on the padding. And we're gonna go ahead and do it for another 20 seconds. Recommended time is 15, but I do it for 20 seconds because that's gonna go ahead and give it more of a vintage look. You know, the dye is gonna go ahead and bleed through a little bit more, and it's gonna give it that vintage look. So there's my 20 seconds. This is done. Peel it like this, and remove your padding, and you have a finished product right there. Okay. So if you have any questions, just go ahead and email us at crafties915@gmail.com. Follow us on Facebook, crafties915, Instagram. And visit our website. Our website is crafties915.com. And if you are interested in buying these white toner transfers, they're very easy to work with. You can offer your customers full color and a lot cheaper than screen printing. Okay, so hit us up, and if you have any questions, I'll be posting some more videos. Just need my camera girl to help me out a little bit more often. But thank you very much.